wrong? Was it alright? Strawberry, yeah. Marshmallow, yeah. Food, she likes food, okay? Jumpy, yeah, jumpy. Sing, nope, never mind. Was okay. Kiss, yes, kiss. Kawaii, obviously, because that's cute in Japanese. Together? No. Forgive? Either way, I think. Sorry. Hi again, Gummy Dwarf! Glad to see you didn't run away on us! Ha ha ha! No, don't worry. This might be a little strange for me. I at least keep my word. This is really annoying for me because I had to restart the whole thing. Well, I'm back in the literature club. Last time I was the last to come in, so everyone else has already started hanging out. Thanks for keeping your promise, coming to home. I hope this isn't too overwhelming of a commitment for you, making you dive headfirst into literature when you're not accustomed to it. Oh, come on. Mikey deserves any slack. Sayori told me you didn't even want to join your clubs this year. And last year too. I don't know if you just come here to play. If you plan to just come and hang out or what. But if you don't take it seriously, then you won't see the end of it. Natsuki, you certainly have a big mouth for someone who keeps a molly collection in a club room. Oh, wrecked, guys, what the heck? Natsuki finds herself stuck between Monica and Marga. Swiftly defeated, Natsuki plops back into her seat. Don't worry, guys. Gummy Dwarf always gives his best as long as he's having fun. He helps me with busy work without me even asking, like cooking, cleaning my room. How dependable. Sayori, that's because your room is so messy, it's distracting. And you almost set your house on fire once. Is that so? Friends, aren't you? I might be a little jealous. How come? You and Kaminoa can be good friends too. Sayori? As usual, Sayori seems oblivious to the weird situation she just put me into. You're even to the point. Brought you something today. You know, wait, Sayori. Me? Not really. Don't be shy. It's really nothing. What is it? Never mind. Sayori made it sound like a big deal when it's really not. What do I do? I'm sorry, Yuri, I wasn't thinking. I guess that means it's up to me to rescue this situation. Hey, don't worry about it. First of all, I wasn't expecting anything in the first place. So any nice gesture from you is a pleasant surprise. It'll make me happy no matter what. Is that so? Yeah, I won't make it a big deal if you don't want it to be. Alright, well, here. Yuri reaches into her bag and pulls out a book. I didn't want you to feel left out, so I picked out a book that I thought you might enjoy. It's a short read, so it should keep your attention even if you don't usually read. And we could, you know, discuss it if you wanted. How is this girl accidentally being so cute? She even picked out a book she thinks I like. Despite me not reading much. Yuri, thank you. I'll definitely read this. I enthusiastically take the book. Phew. Well, you can read it at your own pace. I look forward to hearing what you think. Now that everyone's settled in, I expect Monica to kick off some scheduled activities for the club. But that doesn't seem to be the case. Sayori and Monica are having a cheery conversation in the corner. Yuri's face is already buried in the book. I can't help but notice her intense expression, like she was waiting for this chance. Meanwhile, Natsuki is rummaging around the closet. I hear Natsuki utter an unexpected, exasperated sigh from within the closet. She seems to be annoyed by something. I approach her. In this case, she needs a hand. You looking for something in there? stacked books and boxes across the shelf. Manga. You read manga, right? Sometimes. Manga's one of those things where you can't admit you're really into it until you figure out where the other person stands. How did you know anyway? I heard you bring it up at some point. Besides, it kind of rained on your face. What's that supposed to mean? I see. There's a large volume of manga amidst a stack of various books on the side of the shelves. Ah! Curious, I pulled it out over the what? Out of the stack. I keep moving the tab, changing the tab, yeah. There it is! Natsuki snatches it out of my hand. She then turns to a box of manga and slips the volume right to the middle of the rest. Ah, much better. Seeing a box when one book missing is probably the most irritating sight in the world. I know that feel. I get a closer look at the box she's admiring. Parfait, girls. I wish she likes baking, what the heck? It's a series I've never heard of in my life. That probably means that I it's either way out of my demographic, or it's just simply terrible. If you're gonna judge me, you can do it through the glass of that door. She points to the classroom door. Hey, well, I wasn't judging or anything. I didn't say anything. It was the tone of your voice. But I'll tell you one thing, coming to home. Consider this a lesson straight from the literature club. Don't judge a book by its cover. In fact, Natsuki pulls out the first volume of Parfait Girls in the box. I'm going to show you exactly why. She slammed the book right into my hands. Guys, my water just got magically refilled. I stared at the cover. It features four girls in colourful attire, striking and animated feminine poses. That's rude, by the way. I don't know. I forgot how she does it. But something like that. So yeah, after all, it's exceedingly low. Yeah, last time I read this part, I didn't know what they had mo meant, so I looked it up. So something about feminine or something like that. Don't just stand there. Oh, yeah, I don't understand how to say that, whatever. Natsuki grabs my arm, pulls me out of the closet. Then she takes a seat against the wall, beneath the windowsill. She pats on the ground next to her, seemingly for me to sit there. Wouldn't chairs be more comfortable? I take my seat. Chairs wouldn't work. We can't read at the same time like this. Why is that? Oh, I guess it's close to me. Easier to be close together like this. Don't just say that! You make me feel weird about it! Oh, my curse is on screen. I'm sorry, guys. I forgot I could... Yeah, I'm sorry. Natsuki crosses her arms and scooches an inch away from me. Sorry. I didn't exactly expect her to be sitting this close to her. Hello, either. What's that? I open the book. It's only a few seconds before Natsuki once again inches closer, reclaiming the additional space, while she hopes I won't notice. I do. I can feel her peering off my shoulder, much more eager to begin reading than I am. Wow, how long has it been since I read the beginning? You don't go back and flip through the older volumes every now and then? Not really. Maybe sometimes after I finish the series. Hey, are you paying attention? Yeah, but nothing's really happened yet, so I can't talk at the same. So I can talk at the same time. It looks like it's about a bunch of friends in high school. Typical slice of life affair. I kind of grew in these, since it's rare for the writing to be interesting enough to make up for the lack of plot. So, what should I expect from this? Is there going to be a plot? Obviously, you think I'd enjoy something that didn't have a plot? I mean, well, I guess I know what you're saying. A lot of the beginning is about simple things. Like, there's this really funny chapter where they're obsessed with a guy at the ice cream shop, but that just helps you get to know kinds of people. I know them as well, guys. Everyone makes fun of me for watching animes. They all say I'm a weeaboo. What the heck? Honestly, it takes a lot of effort to find friends that won't charge. So I guess they gravitate towards other losers over time. There's not enough losers in life for me. Hey, what am I up to? 18. But it's probably harder for someone like it's getting caught in her throat. You just don't listen to anything, do you? I already told you. You don't have to go announcing it to the world like you're all self-important. Pretty sure I never actually said that. I said that mostly to myself. Expect